Hello students, welcome back to our physics class. Today we discuss about de Broglie hypothesis. Before we go to de Broglie hypothesis, we first go over previous lecture. That in our previous lecture we discussed that if an electron make transition from higher energy level to lower energy level, it radiate energy. If an electron make transition from higher energy level to lower energy level, it emit radiation in the form of electromagnetic wave. Here Max Planck suggest that wave made up of tiny particles, and that tiny particles is called as photon or quanta. Okay, that all the wave made up of small tiny particles, that is called as photon or quanta. And what is the energy of the photon? That is equal to E equals to h nu, where nu is the frequency of this wave. So what is the wave radiation here occur? That in the region of UV ray, visible light, X-ray, then X-ray, infrared ray, like this. Okay, or here visible light is also. So as light have particle nature, and that energy of that wave, that is equals to E equals to h nu, where nu is the frequency of this wave and nu equals to c by, put the value of nu here, then here we got E equals to hc by lambda. So here h is the Planck's constant. So here Planck suggests that every wave have particle nature. Which is made of photon or which is made of small particle called as photon or quanta. That means every wave have particle nature. On the basis of this concept, de Broglie put an idea that if wave have particle nature, then electron which is exhibit particle nature, as that electron have wave nature. Iska matlab, agar wave, all this waves particle nature so kar raha hai, to electron jo ki particle nature एग्जिबिट कर रहा है, इसका वेव नेचर है क्या? समझ में आया? इलेक्ट्रॉन हैव पार्टिकल नेचर. इन दैट बोर्स एटॉमिक मॉडल वी डिस्कस दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन हैव पार्टिकल नेचर. सो डी ब्रॉग्ली जस्ट पुट एन आइडिया और प्रेडिक्ट दैट जो कि इलेक्ट्रॉन पार्टिकल नेचर शो कर रहा है, इसका वेव नेचर है क्या? ओके, सो ऑन दिस कांसेप्ट डी ब्रॉग्ली प्रेडिक्ट दैट All matter, all moving particles have dual nature. All moving particles have dual nature. That wave nature and particle nature. So what is the wavelength of that moving particle? Dual nature means one is particle nature, another one is wave nature. Okay, then what is the wavelength of that moving particle? That wavelength is called as de Broglie wavelength. And that wavelength, depends on momentum of that particle. That means it depends on mass and velocity of the particle. We know that momentum P equals to mv. So here lambda equals to h by mv, where your lambda is called as de Broglie wavelength of that moving particle, lambda equals to h by p or h by mb. Okay. So as electron, here the topic we discussed that electron have wave nature. Students, all moving particle have dual nature. One is particle nature, another one is wave nature. But that De Broglie wavelength, and that wavelength of that wave is called as De Broglie wavelength. The De Broglie wavelength is only applicable for microscopic particle. That wavelength is exist every particle, every matter, but it's only applicable for microscopic particle. How it possible? We'll later discuss. Now, as here in case of electron, okay, that mass of electron, that is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg, and velocity of electron, we know that the velocity of electron, that is if we calculate that 1 by 137 c by n, where n is the number of orbit. Okay, the velocity of electron, that is 218 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second for the first orbit as n equals to 1. That velocity is nearly equal to the velocity of light. As in case of electron, mass is very less and its velocity is nearly equal to the velocity of light, so it exert wave characteristic. Now we go to how it exist wave characteristic. This is one of the prediction of De Broglie hypothesis. Later, this one is proved by Debreson and Jormer experiment. Later it is discovered, experimented by Debreson and Jormer experiment, that electron have both particle nature as well as wave nature. Okay, now as electron moving around the nucleus, in the first orbit, it exits, okay, one single wave. This time. Okay. So what is that wavelength? Take as its wavelength lambda. Then in that case of second orbit, it exists two waves. First one, this one is the second one. Okay. So here two waves like this. First one is wavelength lambda. And this one too, this one, that is the second one. So what is the total wavelength? That is 2 lambda. Okay, in that second orbit, its wavelength take us 2 lambda. Like in the third orbit, n equals to 3 from this point to this point. Okay, one wave, second wave, and this one is the third wave. Okay, so in the third orbit, it exhibits 3 waves like this one. Okay, so what is the total wavelength? The total wavelength, that is 3 lambda. Like in this case, where the number of orbit 4, in fourth orbit, take us from this point to this point, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So what is the total wavelength? That is 4 lambda. Like this one, 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 4 lambda. Like for nth orbit, the total wavelength, that is n lambda. For nth orbit, the total wavelength n lambda. Now we go to that as it moving in a circular path or revolving around the nucleus, it cover how, what is the path it cover? That circumference of the orbit. It cover the circumference of the orbit. Okay. Take. Here this one is the radius, take as in general form this one Rn. Okay, and electron moving here having velocity Vn and mass m. Okay, so what is the total path it cover? The total path, that is 2 pi Rn. That Rn is the radius. For first orbit, that radius take as R1. For the second orbit, radius take as R2. For the third orbit, radius take as R3. For the fourth orbit, radius take as R4. Likewise, nth orbit, take that radius Rn. So what is the total path covered by that electron? That is 2 pi Rn. In the total 2 pi are in, how many number of waves form? For first orbit, that waves form, that is lambda. For fourth orbit, that wave form 4 lambda. So for nth orbit, that wave form n lambda. So in 2 pi rn circumference, n lambda wave is formed. In 2 pi rn equals to n lambda. Okay. So here lambda equals to h by mv. Put the value of lambda here. Okay. So here 2 pi rn equals to n into h by mvn. For general concept, we put that velocity vn. Okay. Then what is that next step? Okay. That is here mvn goes to here. Okay. That mvn, then here is the rn equals to nh by 2 pi. mvn rn equals to nh by 2 pi. What is mvn rn? This is the angular momentum of the electron, that L equals to nh by 2 pi. Okay. Then this one is the second postulates of Bohr's atomic model, that angular momentum of an electron is equal to integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Okay. The same assumptions is here occur. But what happened? In that case of Bohr's atomic model, they propose that electron revolving around the nucleus in particular circular path. But actual electron revolving around the nucleus, but also it move like wave nature. Okay. Now we go to the de Broglie wavelength is only applicable for microscopic particle, not for the macroscopic particle. How is possible? Now here we calculate de Broglie wavelength for electron and for any macroscopic object. Take as tennis ball of mass 0.1 kg. Okay. Whereas electron have mass, we know that mass of electron, that is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 19 kg. Take here tennis ball having velocity 20 meter per second and electron velocity, that is 10 to the power 6 meter per second. Okay. Now we know that as per the de Broglie hypothesis, lambda equals to h by mv. So here de Broglie wavelength for electron, lambda e equals to h by mve. Put the value of m and v, mass of electron and velocity of electron, and h equals to 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. That is the value. You put this one. Also put here for calculate the de Broglie wavelength for a macroscopic object. Now here what happened? Put all this value. You know that mass of ball and velocity of ball, mass of electron and velocity of electron. So put this value and calculate. So here we got that wavelength of electron, that is 7 to 5 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter, and wavelength of ball, that is 3.3 into 10 to the power minus 34 meter. That means here if we convert that meter into nanometer, 3.3 into 10 to the power minus 25 nanometer, whereas here that velocity, that is 7 to 5 nanometer. So the de Broglie wavelength, if we calculate de Broglie wavelength, that is very very less in case of macroscopic object. So here we conclude that de Broglie wavelength is only applicable for microscopic object. Okay. One of the example of de Broglie wavelength, here question is, what is the de Broglie wavelength associated with an electron moving with speed 5.4 10 to the power 6 meter per second, a ball of mass 15 gram traveling at 30 meter per second. Here question, what is the de Broglie wavelength? We know that lambda equals to h by p or h by mv. Here we calculate an electron what is the de Broglie wavelength? And for a ball of mass 15 gram, what is the de Broglie wavelength? So lambda E equals to h by m e b e for electron, and for ball same lambda m equals to h by m b b b. Put all the value, then we solve this one as well. H equals to 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second divided by mass of electron. We know that mass of electron 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg into velocity of electron. Here velocity of electron that is given 5.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second. Okay, you solve this one. Next here, h that is 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second divided by mass of body that is 15 gram that is 15 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg. Okay, 15 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg into velocity of ball. Velocity of ball that is 30 meter per second. Okay, solve this one also. Okay, if we solve this two, we got in case of wavelength of electron, we got 0.134 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter, and here we got 8.8 into 10 to the power minus 34 meter. 8.8 into 10 to the power minus 34 meter. Okay. Here we go to another question. The question is, a particle is moving 3 times as fast as an electron. That means the particle velocity here is 3 times the velocity of electron. The ratio of the de Broglie wavelength of the particle to that of an electron, that of an electron is 1.813 into 10 to the power minus 4. The ratio of de Broglie wavelength of the particle, de Broglie wavelength of the particle to that of the electron is equals to 1.813 into 10 to the power minus 4. Calculate the particle mass. Okay, now first one here, the de Broglie wavelength of the particle equals to h by mass of the particle into velocity of the particle. Similarly, de Broglie wavelength of electron, that is h by mass of electron and velocity of electron. Yes. So first one, you put this two value here. Equals to h by BBP minus h by MEBE. HH cancel. Okay. Then here answer is MEBE by MPBP. Okay. Next, this one equals to 1.813 into 10 to the power minus 4. And velocity VP equals to 3 times of VE. Then put here MEBE by MP into 3VE equals to 1.813 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, VE cancel. Then MP, mass of the particle. Okay, this one equals to ME divided by 3 into 1.813 into 10 to the power minus 4. Then mass of electron, here given that mass of electron, that is equals to, put the value 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg divided by 3 into 1.813 into 10 to the power minus 4 and solve this one. Solving this formula, we got 1.675 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. That mass here, mass of the particle is near nearly equal to the mass of proton or neutron. Okay? Here, question is, the equivalent wavelength of a moving electron has the same value as that of a photon having energy 6 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule. First one, the moving electron has the same value as that of the photon. Moving electron has the same value as that of photon having an energy 6 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule. That means here the photon energy 6 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule. Photon energy. Okay? Calculate the momentum of the electron. Calculate the momentum of the electron. Achha, momentum, mass into velocity. Momentum of the electron, that is equal to mass of the electron into velocity of the electron. First one, students, lambda equals to hy mv. Okay. Here we calculate this one. mev. So what is mev? mev equals to hy lambda e. Okay. We know that e equals to h nu. Nu equals to c by lambda. Put this one, h into c by lambda. So here that question is, that photon, same value as that of photon, which have the same value as that of photon? The equivalent wavelength of the electron, the equivalent wavelength of the electron has the same value as that of photon. Okay, so then lambda e equals to hc by e. Put this value here, h by hc by e. Okay, then he by hc cancel, hh cancel. Then mevA equals to e by c. What is e? That value is given, 6 into 10 to the power minus 7 joule divided by c, 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Okay. Then you calculate this one. Okay. Then 3 divided by 6, that is 2 into here 10 to the power. Answer is here.